Ben Margera is someone who's had a very hard life, despite being a part of one of the most beloved and infamous shows in the history of MTV and beyond via Jackass. He was one of the original members and was someone who went and did a lot for them, and suffered as a result. His physical and mental health deteriorated, and though he did get better in a way, one has to wonder if it was enough. Because not only was he fired from the fourth film that'll release soon enough, but now he's suing them for doing it. We'll break it down for you, but before we do that, go ahead and do us a favor by leaving a like on the video, subscribing to the channel, and hitting the bell icon so you never miss an upload from us. And with that being said, let's get into the video. Do you want to win an iPhone 12? Maybe a MacBook Pro? How about $500 cash? All you have to do is comment the secret hidden message somewhere in this video. That's it. Oh, and leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel so we can keep affording these giveaways. Winner will be announced at the last day of each month. Thanks for watching and good luck. Number 5. The lawsuit. Ben Margera filed a lawsuit on Monday against Paramount, Johnny Knoxville, and director Spike Jonze, alleging that he was wrongfully fired from the upcoming fourth installment of the Jackass film franchise. Margera, one of the stars of the original TV series and the subsequent films, was fired last fall after allegedly testing positive for Adderall, violating the terms of a wellness agreement he signed with the film's producers.
Back at his co-stars after he was fired from Jackass 4 in February for violating the terms of his contract, which is basically he failed to remain sober.
Margera has been in and out of rehab several times over the last decade. According to his lawsuit, Jonze, director Jeff Tremaine, and Knoxville coerced him into signing the wellness agreement while he was in rehab in 2019 and said that if he didn't, he would be excluded from Jackass forever. The suit claims that he signed the agreement without being given the chance to run it by an attorney. The agreement required regular drug and alcohol tests, as well as a prescription medication regimen, according to the suit. The suit alleges that Margera was fired after testing positive for Adderall, even though he's taken Adderall by prescription for 10 years.
Now he did fail the drug test and the breathalyzer while shooting the movie, and Bam posted a video on Insta on Sunday saying that he is getting help.
The suit likens Margera's treatment to Britney Spears' conservatorship case, alleging that he has been victimized as a result of his mental health issues. Paramount's inhumane treatment of Margera cannot be countenanced, the suit states. Margera was made to endure psychological torture in the form of a sham wellness agreement, and then ultimately terminated for his protected class status due to his medical condition and his complaints about defendants' discriminatory conduct towards him. The suit also claims that Jackass Forever, which is due out in October, makes use of many of Margera's contributions.
Just to give everybody a valid update about where I'm at, I am visiting a very special lady. I'm not going to give her name out, but she has helped celebrities like Brian.
Knoxville addressed the situation in an interview with GQ in May. I don't want to get into a public back and forth with Bam, Knoxville said at the time. I just want him to get better. Better might just be what Bam is fighting against here, because he would no doubt say he didn't get better because of them. And when you look at the history of the show and all that happened to its stars, you can see why he's a bit angry about getting kicked off. Number 4, Origins.
He hits this certain frequency when he cries. I can't even think straight. It makes me go more bad than what Johnny Knoxville and Tremaine made me go through with their stupid contract.
MTV kicked off the 2000s by introducing Jackass to the world. The beloved cast included Johnny Knoxville, Bam Margera, Steve-O, Chris Pontius, Ryan Dunn, Jason Wee Man Acuna, and others. Knoxville, Spike Jonze, and Jeff Tremaine were the brains behind the reality comedy series. Jackass combined the sensibilities of boundary-pushing skateboard magazine Big Brother's videos with the antics chronicled in CKY, the video series Margera and his circle of friends introduced in 1999. Fans tuned in to watch the cast of 9 performing outrageous stunts and pranks on each other, while seemingly having a blast together. The controversial show ran for 3 seasons on MTV between October 2000 and February 2002.
Has betrayed me, abandoned me, rejected me. Not all of them. I love all of them and they love me back, but it's specifically Jeff Tremaine and Johnny Knoxville.
And was often criticized for promoting dangerous antics and behavior. The hit show inspired countless spin-offs, including Viva La Bam, Bam's Unholy Union, Homewrecker, Wild Boys, and Dr. Steve-O, as well as five feature films including Jackass the Movie, Jackass No. 2, Jackass Presents Matt Hoffman's Tribute to Evel Knievel, Jackass 3D, and Jackass Presents Bad Grandpa. Despite the franchise's success, there was plenty of turmoil behind the scenes, with cast members Steve-O and Margera dealing with drug and alcohol abuse. Dunn died in a car accident while driving intoxicated in Pennsylvania on June 20th, 2011. His death sent his castmate and best friend Margera on a downward spiral that left him even more dependent on alcohol. Margera's addiction and mental health troubles caused a rift between him and his family, hurt his career, and affected his involvement in the Jackass franchise.
So, I feel like my family has done everything horrible to me and made me jump through hoops and walk on eggshells, which is impossible, and strung me along like a f***.
Which has led us to the lawsuit that we're talking about now. Margera appeared on the first episode of the Jackass MTV series in October of 2000. He was an integral part of the reality series as well as the movies. He became a fan favorite and went on to have great success with his own spin-off series Viva La Bam and Bam's Unholy Union. The TV star, who has struggled with alcohol abuse since his 20s, was often seen on camera under the influence during his reality shows and in behind-the-scenes footage from the Jackass movies. But if you want to know the real moment where he lost it all, that would be his best friend dying. Number 3. How Ryan Dunn's death affected him.
Okay, so Steve-O commented on his post writing, "Bam, the two people you're saying wronged you, Knoxville and Tremaine, are the same two people who organized the intervention which saved my life."
Following Ryan Dunn's death in 2011, Margera said his drinking intensified. The former professional skateboarder said 2012 was the year that he lost control of his drinking after his skating career was halted by bone spurs he developed from skating. He was in and out of rehab for years following his first visit, and in 2016, he talked to people about having to relearn his skateboarding tricks after years of abusing alcohol. "I took a 5-year hiatus from skating because I had bone spurs. So instead, I was making money by doing nightclub appearances, which basically was shooting photos and taking shots with the locals," he said. "So I was bag wasted every night, and eventually was like, this has to stop. Once I woke up in my own puke and piss, I knew I had to cut it off."
"Everyone bent over backwards to get you in the movie, and all you had to do was not get loaded. You've continued to get loaded. It's that simple. We all love you every bit as much as we all say we do, but nobody really loves you."
He also opened up about his mental health issues, including his struggles with anxiety and eating disorders, and things continued to fall against him as he would relapse and was even robbed at gunpoint while traveling in Colombia one time. "I just arrived in Cartagena alone, and I took a taxi, a random one from the airport to here, and I wouldn't speak Spanish. They couldn't speak English, and they translated on their phone to read, 'Empty your wallet,' as they put a gun on their lap to show it to me. So I did, and I had $500. He said in the video, "They let me go. Welcome to Colombia." When you add that to everything else that had been happening with him, you can see why the loss of being in the fourth movie, despite doing various things that they told him to do, would be so devastating.
We want Bam to be happy and healthy and to get the help he needs. We tried to push that along. I think that's all I really want to say about it. I don't want to get into a public back and forth with Bam.
While it's true that it wasn't his whole life, the franchise was a major part of it, and as a result, him not being there for the revival is something that might just rub him in the worst way, in that it would break him not being there, or at the very least, break him even more. Number 2. What will come of this lawsuit? That is a very good question, because right now things are very much up in the air in terms of all that's going on with this lawsuit. One could argue that Bam might just be trying to get money out of this so that he's paid for his dues, if you will. But others will likely say that this is a very personal battle that he's fighting and is trying to get acknowledgement for what he went through and what others allegedly put him through.
Chesco says this is sad. Yeah, I mean, I find this a little sad to him because, yeah, it doesn't seem like Bam is in the greatest state, even in that video.
Yeah, I mean, we're not medical professionals. We don't know what he...
The movie itself is done, so there's likely no option for him to go and be in that. But if there's somehow a fifth movie, he likely would fight to get in that via this lawsuit. Number 1. The legacy of the show. Jackass has always been a show that was going to have a complicated legacy. After all, it was a show about guys hurting themselves for entertainment. Many of the cast are scarred in their own ways, including one walking away in order to get his life back on track.
Medical medical professionals. We don't know what he's going through, but you know, there is obviously a reason why they removed him from the film. I mean, he is one of the original cast members of that franchise. So
another passing away, and now Bam is suing his former friends and compatriots in order to get recompense for all that came before. Regardless of what happens with the fourth film, this is what people are going to remember. This is what people are gonna talk about, that a reckless show didn't take care of its people, and this was the result. And there you have it, everyone, a look at the situation with Bam Margera and how his lawsuit might just affect the entire Jackass team from top to bottom. Do you think that he has a case here? Do you think he'll be able to get some reparations from it all should it go his way? Or is this just the latest in an attempt to get attention from the crew after all he gave them? Go ahead and let us know what you think in the comments down below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.